few days ago, we were talking about, because of recent governors and the presidency, we've been talking about promoting agriculture, and yesterday I was discussing with someone, no one seems to know how the government, whether at federal or state level, wants to go about this. But I want to commend the brains behind this initiative. I think it's worthwhile. Then I want to know also, when is the takeoff date?
And during the documentary, it was said that what was said was just 5 million naira as a grand prize. Any other prize is to be won. So this that to motivate people, even the star winner, the ambassadors, are they coming as a farmer, or they just bear the title ambassador, and after a while another ambassador emerge, and another ambassador emerge, so what are the things they are going to do that will be of a record, setting agenda for others, so that to be, since it's a season project.
Over the years, there has been calls on the youth to participate in agriculture, and the need for us to, turn to agriculture. But my question is this: for example, is IITA or the government or other investors doing anything? Agriculture is a capital-intensive business. If you subsistence farming cannot make you a millionaire, so if you want you to go into agriculture, you have to go in it big. The Nigerian youth does not want to. When easily you can sit down with your laptop and make quick money, and you now tell me to farm for 6 months, are you providing funds? What is the IITA doing in terms of providing funds? Because agri is big business, it's capital intensive. Are you going to provide empowerment aids for youths that are going to participate in this program?
What IITA and the corporate Farmers Reality TV show can help do is to enable the youth to write proper business plans. You have to have a whole plan how you're going to acquire your resources, your inputs, where are you going to sell, are you going to do post-harvest processing, value addition, so that you make good profits. So we want to empower youth to leave the program ready to write business plans that are bankable, that banks can finance. And yes, we do hope that there will be special programs that make it a bit easier for the youth to get the loans and the resources they need to get started.
But how did we get to have a bank of industry start funding movies and entertainment? That's quite amazing, because the bank of industry, when it was NIDB, which was the Nigerian Industrial Development Bank, was all about big industry. But they suddenly realized that making movies is big industry. So agriculture is big industry. If you're doing Dudu Osun, for example, which is a local soap, which we call Poche Dudu in Yoruba land, if you package that, the right branding and whatever, you can make that go global. Emufufun Oguro, Fura the Nunu. Now, who says that that cannot be an international product that is alcoholic, that is natural, agri-based anywhere in the world? And you can make palm wine be an alcoholic wine, drink champagne, for example. Now, Emufufu could be Nigeria's champagne. That is what agriculture reality TV show is all about. And you don't need $100 million to do it, to set it up. It doesn't take much. Our parents and our grandparents fried gari using firewood. Now, what does it take just to get gas to them? Isn't it? A little bit of gas, whatever. And you just put it on, it becomes a lot safer. It helps our women and reduces the danger of women using firewood and things like that to fry gari, for example. But if you put a small cottage industry together, in the Southwest alone, not to talk of the North, and in South Nigeria, we can go back and do a lot of things with 100,000 naira to start a small agro-allied business in producing toothpaste, like Dabo was using, was doing. And you had a lot that IITA has installed that the eyes have not seen, that I've seen them here and using it for the first time in my life. I think the motivation is this. We're trying to get not just the youth, but also the big businesses and the governments at state, federal, local governments, and other agencies to see agriculture the way the government is seeing entertainment. The immediate past president, and I felt a little bit bad when he says, well, when he goes out in the international airports around the world, well, actors and actresses are better first recognized than journalists. And I said, I spent about 30 years of my life being a journalist. I could as well be Davido. I was singing, when I see the president, he's going to recognize me first. Because everywhere in the world, actors and actresses are recognized. And the president said, give them billions, 10, 20 billion naira, let them get the entertainment industry going. Now, when we have the critical mass, IITA is here, breeding, putting together the next generation of youth as agropreneurs already. That is the first thing. Now, if all of us come out of here and visit the Central Bank of Nigeria today and say, we are the IITA agropreneurs, that is a critical mass. They're not going to open the vault tomorrow and say, take money. But again, government does not just go about and say, look, let's just give money to anyone. There has to be a critical mass. There has to be a platform. And that is what this reality TV show is doing. If you walk as a single individual to back of industry, perhaps you're not going to get much money. But if you say, well, we are from a shoe state, we're about 5-10 of us, we are agro-premiums because we're a reality TV show, this is what has happened. That is what you get. So it's capital intensive, the money will come out, but again, how do you get the premiums? How many are into agriculture in what Hess Holdings with Tony Olumelu is doing across Africa, using the Nigeria as a pilot case? Now that is, this is another innovation along that line in which you can have thousands of people who you have, Dangote Foundation, for example, or Theophilus Danjuma Foundation, is look, I've done enough with oil, and you have all the generals who have done agriculture in Nigeria who will be willing to tutor a number of new agribusiness. They know it. They know the rudiments, but people can still learn. So this crop of new Nigerians, the new generation, this is like an incubation process to bring the new yield of Nigerians who see agriculture beyond farming. Now we need to think agriculture not as farming. We're still going around with farming mentality. Universities teach farming. They hardly teach agriculture. They don't teach agribusiness. They don't teach agro-art. And that's why IITA has raised the game beyond farming into what we call agriculture beyond food.
We tend to appeal to youth to see the reason why they should be in this for the long haul. Yes, your intention, your focus, your orientation before now might have been to sit down in front of the laptop and make crazy money in 30 minutes, in 1 hour, as compared to agriculture. We want to appeal to those whose hearts will be given to agriculture. Now, we would have fund managers that are going to be, you know, willing. There is money everywhere, as against the illusion or perception that it's hard to get funding for agriculture. Doctors spoke about business plan. A lot of our youths are lacking those soft skills to put down, put together pen to paper, and, you know, write out what it is that you want to do. Banks relate, and financiers relate in terms of naira and kobo. They want to see that you have your thoughts well put out together properly before they put their money there. And who would you carry that bankable investment to? I ask you honestly, who would you carry to and tell them that you have IITA backing you up with technical expertise that they will not be comfortable? They will be comfortable to give you money. So we are saying that with what we want to do, it will be easier even accessing funds. You will get the training that is required to manage those businesses the risks that are there have been demystified. And once they see that, hey, they will pack with money because they want to make more money. I mentioned 5 million, we said in cash and kind, specifically 5 million and thereabout. There are also going to be scholarships for courses and trainings that will further equip our winners to practice agriculture and agribusiness successfully. Globally, we have foreign aids that have committed to sponsoring and handing out scholarship to the winners that emerge from, you know, this competition. And for some of them also, they will be bringing, they'll be asked to bring in proposals as to what they want to do, and support will be given to them in cash, in kind, materials, machineries that we can support them with, and the likes. So the details will come to you as to when we are kicking off. Second quarter 2016, tentatively, that's what the plans on the ground are for right now. By second quarter 2016, we're going live.
I want to give my special thanks to the Director General who is not present here. Amongst us, we call him Baba Ibi, because he has always believed in us, he has always supported and mentored us. And this morning he reiterated that by his statement that he believes in the youth. And the Deputy Director General, Dr. Dashiu, he has been a strong supporter. And he also made in a statement today that youth are fantastic people to work with. We appreciate that. And to our partners here, the CFIL, we appreciate the innovative idea you brought to the table to engage the youth. Seeing is believing. Through this, you possibility of the youth, we appreciate this innovative idea, bringing it to IITA to be a host partner in this innovation. And to the man that has anchored this program, Mr. Govin Aksa, we thank you for efficiently running the program all through. And to IITA staff that have been planning overnight, weeks ahead for this program that if they're successful today, they are a dedicated and motivated team. We thank you all too. And we thank all invited guests present that have sat and listened attentively during this press conference. And most importantly, the media and team who are here. We hope you get the message and pass it accurately to the youth out there across Africa. That yes, indeed, agriculture is the future. Thank you.